Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you?
Hey guys, and welcome back to the Sunderland Football Manager 2020 series. I think this is episode 18. As you can see here, we are top of the league still. Say we are top of the league. And if I'm going to go and show you what happened in last episode, if you haven't seen it, go watch it. But I'm going to go through last episode first. So we started it off just a little win at home against Luton, who was second at the time. So no biggie. I mean, we only scored 7 goals. Aidan Barlow, Scott Fraser, Balgoon hat-trick, and Leon Clark getting 2 when Balgoon picked up a bit of a knock. It's okay, though. Don't worry. And then we went to, Southport came to us in the second round. Owen McFarlane scored an own goal, the goalkeeper. We pushed and pushed. We had about 33 shots, I think, that game. And we only won 1-0. So, disappointing scoreline, but important win to get the objectives done for the season of getting to the second round. Then, I haven't even told you this because it was the last game of last episode. Ita Karanka got the sack as we beat Hull City 4-0 at their place. Max Power with a hat-trick, a penalty, a free kick and an absolute wonder shot with Balgoon getting a goal, of course, and James McLean getting sent off. You love to see that. The three games that I played off screen here. Blackpool, first game, 2-0 win. Duncan Watmore, Connor Townsend getting the goals. Connor Townsend were a bit of a worldie as well. He had a really good game, as you can see. Got an 8.9 rating. Then we had Leicester under-23s in the Leeson.com trophy. I think this was the round of 16. They took the lead. And then we got an equaliser through Faraguia. And we actually got a winner with Tom Ahmed, which I thought was a winner, until Faraguia got another one in the same minute of play. And then we had Forest Green, which was a really disappointing game. 2-0 up. Then they scored through Gavin Riley. Then they got a defender sent off. I thought, oh, this is going to be easy. Then the score 1 minute after he got sent off, so not the best of results there at the new lawn. In today's episode, as you can see, we have 3 games. We are at home to Coventry, who are in the playoffs. Going to be a hard game, that one. Then we have Stevenage, who are in 10th away. Another difficult one. And MK Dons, who are a team to be reckoned with. Although, you know what happened last time, 5-1 win. Also, if you did not know already, we have QPR in the third round of the FA Cup. A meh team. I would have liked a Premier League team in that, like the Carabao. And in the Leeson.com, we have Liverpool's under-23s at home at the Stadium of Light, which is going to be televised for some weird reason. So here is the team for the game against Coventry. McLaughlin in net. 09 is in for the injured Emmanuel. Flanagan, Kurt and Townsend is the back four. Power and Reese in CDM. Watmore, Fraser and Barlow in the like cam and wing roles. And then Balogun is up front, hoping to try and get, I think it's his 20th goal in the next game. Doing very well for a 19-year-old. Balogun, straight from kickoff. Can we put ourselves 1-0 up? It's a good save. Max Power to whip a ball in. He doesn't. He puts it down the line to Aidan Barlow, who puts it in. Allen heads it away. And Lang can come forward with it. If we can get there, we can't. Undluku, who was the best player in the league at one point, has fallen off a bit now. Dabo to McFadzian. Playing a good bit of passing here. They've switched it over the top to Mason. Gone back to the goalkeeper. If we can get the pressure on, as we are doing. Oh, it's just gone over his head to Lang. And they've gone forward. Here he is. Undone, Lou. Oh, it's a good save. Allen. To whip a ball in. Hyams got up highest. 09's going to clear it. We need to get out. Dabo, bad control. Balogun can run through at net. Can this be his 20th goal? And it's straight at Miazek. Half time, and it's been quite an even game. They've had chances, we've had chances. I'm going to say we're not doing badly at all because we have had more of the chances, even though they've had the better chances. I'm going to say they're capable. But hopefully we can get a goal. 09. Throw to Reese. Back to Reese. After a 1-2, and Barlow's just had it over the post. well, not over the post, to the side of the post, and should have scored there. As they've got a chance here. I'm going to make a sub. I'll let this play out. Higham to Mason. Jabello. Through to Shipley. Don't let him get a shot off. They have done. And it wasn't a good save from McLaughlin. Over the top of everyone. It's gone back in. And he's got an open net. And Callum Lang has scored for Coventry. Oh, not how we wanted to go down. It was a corner. It was a set piece routine. Put a cross net. Kelly had the shot. It was blocked. And Callum Lang's put it in for his third goal. Lundaloo. Watmore. Through to Balogun. Come on, you've had plenty of chances. You've got to bury one now. And he does. His 20th goal of the season. Assisted by Duncan Watmore, who is having a very good season by his standards. It's 1-1 here with Coventry. I'd like a win to take us further away from Fleetwood. But we've got ourselves back on level terms. Kerr. Tries to whip it forward. It's not a good ball. But it falls straight back to us. Power with that ball to Balogun. Can he score here? It is that partnership. And it is a goal. We take the lead from behind against Coventry at home at the Stadium of Light. His 21st of the season. Florian Balogun. What a guy for the future. And Max Power is another player like Duncan Watmore having an excellent season as we stay at top of the league. Corner ball from Allen. We don't want to concede late on here. Fraser's kicked it away. And Faragir can pick it up. That was a good ball. Can he get past his man? He cannot, but Duncan Watmore's there. Even though he's on left wing now. He whips it in. It doesn't fall to anyone. Tom Flanagan's picked it up. To Mumba, who's come on for Luke 09. Through the gap. Balogun, can he get a hat-trick? No, he's too far out wide. Gives it back to Mumba, who puts it in the box. It's fallen to Allen. Mumba, come on, we can get a chance here. Duncan Watmore. Magooch over the top to Faragir. And what a save from Mjazek. On loan from Leeds, that was a really good save. Apologies, guys. I just saw my camera was not on. Tell the boys it was excellent. I'm going to say we got away with it. Because we kind of did. I know it's going to frustrate some. But we got away with it. We didn't play the best. As you can see, we've got an achievement for attack. We are first in the league. Even though we have lost double games Fleetwood has. We have only drawn three. We're 5 points clear at the top of the league and nine points clear of Doncaster at the bottom of the playoffs. Everything's looking good at the moment. I say that, though, as we go into a difficult game against Stevenage. Okay, guys, so we've gone and signed a new under-23s coach if everything goes to plan, and it's Phil Neville. We have just signed Phil Neville. A 3.5-star one. I don't know if he's as good as Gary Neville, but we've got him just in before Stevenage, and I'll show you the team that we're going to play away at Stevenage. Yep, Neville is in. We have got McLaughlin, 09, Flanagan, Kerr, Townsend, Reese, Power, Watmore, Fraser, Barlow, and Balogun. It's the exact same team, but there might be some rotation for MK Dons, as we've only got a 2-day break between the games. Balogun, out to 09, Watmore. In the first 17 seconds, can he get a goal? It's a good save. Duncan Watmore. Through to Balogun. I think that was Luke 09 who whipped it through. And Balogun has his second, 22nd, shall I say, goal of the season. Definitely not his second. Assisted by yours truly, Luke 09. I thought it was after it just coming down the line. First time ball over the top. Beautiful touch. And it's outside of the box. Driven shot into the bottom left corner. Balogun has got another chance here. Oh! This guy is deadly. Ludovic Reese with the assist. But this game is all about, as many games have been, it's all about Florian Balogun with his 23rd goal of the season. Oh, the keeper just came to catch it and he just poked it past him. Bottom right this time, though. Watmore. He's running down the wing. Gives it to Rhys. 09. Whips it forward to Balogun again, like he did in the first half, and he scored again. Oh, the keeper should have saved that. O'Neill with another assist. But of course, it's Balogun's first half. It's in 10 minutes. I didn't even realise that. The first 10 minutes of the game. Balogun has a hat-trick. Scully got a hand to it. We are absolutely going to smash Stevenage if we keep up. Max Powell with a corner kick. Whips it in. Looking for Balogun. Drops to Rhys. Oh, beautiful little flick. And Scott Fraser this time. Rhys with his second assist. He's joining 09 on two assists now as Scott Fraser gets his fourth of the season. And 20 minutes in, we're 4-0 up away from home. I think we can arrange the promotion bus right now. Max Powell with a corner kick. Whips it in. And that is Balogun. And he has four in this game. We're 5-0 up at half-time. It's 25th of the season. Assisted by yours truly. Again, Max Power. Them two have a deadly link-up. We need to prioritise signing Balogun up in the summer. Barlow puts it through to Scott Fraser. Can he get two? He has. 6-0 before half-time. I was wrong. His fifth of the season. His second of the game. Oh my Jesus. Makami's scoring now. And my striker, we never had a problem with him scoring. Jesus, 30 goals between them both. And that's just a low drive past the keeper to make it sick. Half time. I think I'm the happier of the both managers at half time. 6-0 up away from home. I'm definitely not going to say complacent. Very pleased with the performance. Look at all the ratings. The only one who hasn't got a good rating is John McLaughlin. But that's because he's had nothing to do. Fraser over the top to Balogun. He's got there. And it's his fifth goal. Straight from kickoff. Oh my God. 7-0 against... I thought 7-0 against Luton at home was good. It's only just kicked off in the second half. And we're 7-0 up against Stevenage. Rhys whips it in. Falling to Watmore. Watmore can put it in again. At the back post is Aidan Barlow for his sixth goal. And on the hour mark, we make it 8-0 against Stevenage at their place. I think the fans might be asking for their manager's head after this. Even though they're doing well and they got promoted, 8-0 isn't flattering. Townsend goes inside to Robson. Robson goes over the top to Balogun. Can he get his six? Oh, that is a magnificent save from Scully. Mumba. Is it to Watmore? Back to Mumba. Tries to put it over the top. Can't do. He's got it again, though. And can he thread it through to Hemed? Tomer Hemed's going to pick up on that. And Tomer Hemed off the bench gets a goal. It's 9. It could be double digits. We've still got 2 minutes left on the clock plus added on time as Tomer Hemed gets his fifth goal. It's a shame because any other striker, if he came off the bench and scored one like that, would get a place in the team. With Balogun, absolutely no chance. So as you can see, 30 goal difference. We sit top of the league, still keeping that 5-point gap on Fleetwood. I mean, the promotion playoff spots, they're moving all the time. Coventry's dropped out. Stevenage, who we just beat, they were in it at one point. Luton's dropped off. I think it's every team we beat, we knock out of the playoffs. As you can see here, I know it's very dark with the face cam, I apologise for that, but that is our best win ever. As previous was 9-1 against Newcastle. But this 9-0 win against Stevenage, although Newcastle's a rival and that's a big win, and this is in League One, it's still the best game in their history. So here's the team sheet for the game at home against MK Dons. More of the same like we did against Stevenage, please. McLaughlin in net. 09, Flanagan, Kerr, Townsend, Rhys, Power, Watmore, Fraser, Barlow and Balogun is the team. Unchanged. And if we win this, and hopefully Fleetwood just lose, the gap will be 8 points. Reagan Poole to Holland. Porth in the middle to Darcy. Puts it over the top. Chapman's going to keep it in. They skip past the tackle, put it in the box. We've had to clear it. Only as far as Reagan Poole again. Gives it to Giblet. To Gibson. Lewis Gibson this time. It was Liam last time. Giblet to Darcy. It's gone straight through the man. Sam Sturridge is through. And we're 1-0 down. 13th goal of the season for Sam Sturridge. After a 9-0 win. Stevenage. We now losing to MK Dons. Chapman down the left-hand side here. Skips past 09. Puts the ball in the box again. We're not really doing that well this game. As Aidan Barlow can come away with it. Just pumps it upfield looking for Balogun. Like anyone would do with him in your team. What more to Power. Who can power his way forward to Fraser. And I thought that was in the back of the net. Half time. We are 1-0 down. We've had more shots. I'm going to have to say I expect to see a much better showing. After we win that game 9-0, we come to us home ground and we're 1-0 down after having three shots against us. It's embarrassing. Cross in. Sam Sturridge. It's 2. Even before the Almar. 2-0 to MK Dons. This game, which was promising, has completely gone away from us. Ball in. And it's headed in. Neil Faraguia off the bench for Duncan Watmore. I think that's it, to be honest. I think the players are just too fatigued after that last match. And as I did say, they come thick and fast. This was on a Monday. The last game was on a Saturday. And I've brought someone else on and he scored straight away. 09 to Tom Ahmed. Gone to 4-4-2. Whips the ball in. It's gone past everyone. And Florian Balogun reacts first. We've come from 2-0 down to 2-2. This team never gives up. Tom Ahmed with the assist. And Balogun with his 27th goal of the season. Just let that sink in. 27 goals. It was over Cargill's head. And he just reacted easy. Put it in. Williams on the right-hand side whips the ball in. It's hit the post. Oh, we've been really lucky this game. Post. Missed a penalty. Jeez. As we kick it up to Tom Ahmed. Goes over the top looking for Balogun. To Williams. These are going to play it out from the back. 2-2 draw. With MK Dons. I say unlucky, boys. It was a good game. It was a very good game. Good challenge. And as you can see, before the next game in the FA Cup against QPR, the transfer window opens. But that is it for the end of this episode, because you can't hardly see me. It's gone that dark. We have a 5-point gap between us and second, which is Oxford United now. Fleetwood falling into the playoffs. I am going to play these three games off screen, so it's QPR, Oxford and Liverpool. Actually, I might save that for you later. I might keep you on edge for that. If you want to see that, tune into the next episode. But unfortunately, guys, this is going to end right here. Hope you have enjoyed. Like, comment, share and subscribe. And I'll see you all in a bit. Peace.